guys, what's going on? It is Ash here coming at you today in Raid Shadow Legends. Today we're going to talk about the three main types of arena teams and how to build them successfully. So obviously this works in regular arena too, but we're going to show it in today's video in tag team arena because, well, it's ideal, right? We have three teams to work with, three teams for each of the main metas. Also, just a side note, guys, as we mentioned here a lot on the channel, there is more than one way, or three ways in this case, to build an arena team. There's plenty of hybrid opportunities for you guys to experiment and have fun beyond just these three main archetypes. But if I was to make three main archetypes, which you kind of start with, which you should at least be thinking about in terms of what is this team trying to do, these would be the three that I would outline for you guys. Last kind of caveat before we jump into it here, not caveat, last mention is, I think I already mentioned this, but thanks again to the Plarium team for sending me a Clan Boss t-shirt. Pretty cool, man. And you know what I say about Clan Boss t-shirts, right? It's a chick magnet, right? You gotta rock this thing. You go to the beach, yeah, Clan Boss, man. Ultra Nightmare, baby. All right, so here we go, guys. Let's jump into the arena tag team. Now, I have, I have not looked at any of these teams. I'm just going to kind of go down the line here. And one thing I like to do in my arena team is kind of look at the opponents and switch out. I usually keep the same cast of characters in terms of champions, but sometimes I switch them out based on the enemy team. In this case, my first team has more immunity gear on them. So I want them to actually go second against Torment on this team, okay? So anyway, with that being said, here's the three teams. Up first is going to be a control team, my personal favorite team to have in terms of an archetype. I love control. Second team is going to be all-out nuke. And then third team is going to be deny. And we'll talk about each of these teams as we kind of go through this tag team match, right? So I think that we feel pretty good about this squad. And again, we'll talk about substitutions I have. These are my main arena teams. So I know it is a legendary heavy, but we'll talk about the roles rather than just the individual champions, okay? So all of these teams would be probably platinum viable as well, what I'm showing you guys today, just, you know, in full transparency. So team number one. Team number one and team number two, control and nuke, there's a lot of crossover. You can make great control nuke hybrid teams as well. In fact, I do a lot of that myself. And my main arena team is kind of a hybrid between these two first teams. I'll talk about what it is. Instead of Apothecary, I have Molly Tankard in my second team. But I wanted to kind of really illustrate the archetypes and stay strong to the base of what they truly are. So in nuke and control, speed is your best friend. Speed is really what matters 90% of the time in those two archetypes, no matter what. If you go first, you're way more likely to win. But you do need some strategy beyond just speed. What are you doing after you take the first turn is also important. So on this hybrid team, or not hybrid, excuse me, on this kind of a control team, what we're doing here is Bastion is my main champion. We do have some speed in Kaimar as a speed or a lead. And we have Lissandra as kind of a control via her turn meter manipulation. She has an ability that's going to reduce the turn meter of my opponents. Again, trying to get Bastion to go first, essentially. Once Bastion goes, we're going to be looking great, and Krutrax is going to be able to kill all the enemies. So again, we'll talk about each of these roles rather than focusing so hard on, you know, the individual champion as we go through this. So let's start it out here with a Energize. Again, placing a 30% increased speed on my allies, fills the turn meter of allies by 30% while decreasing the opponent's turn meter. So there you go. Next up is going to be Kaimar. So the order is a little bit off here. Ideally, I would have Bastion going before Kaimar on this team, but for all intents and purposes, we're just going to go ahead and put the opponents to sleep, and now we're going to wake them all up. Again, that's why we had Bastion before Kaimar, but again, Bastion, what he's going to do here is he is my control champion on this team. Other control champions, they're typically a little bit more rare in the game, a little bit more difficult to get. Umbral Enchantress, Molly Tankard, Warlord. There's a lot of just good provoke champ. Krisk, there's a lot of good provoke champions. And champions, Hegemon, Tormund, freeze champions, right? Anybody who's stunning, freezing, or preventing, or increasing cooldowns, or preventing the opponents from taking a turn. So Stinging Blast on Bastion, one of my personal faves. Attacks all enemies, increases the cooldown of all the target skills by two turns. So essentially, after he goes, there's going to be a two-turn cooldown on all of the champions, the enemies' abilities, except for their A1. So that's going to really largely negate them the rest of the match. And he does a decent amount of damage, too. So here they go. They're attacking here, only using their A1s. We take some damage, but now we can just kind of get into it here. I'm actually going to go, who's next? It looks like Trutraxa is probably next here. Just in case, I'm going to land and energize here on Valk. And then we're going to take down Tayrell first, because he is going to take a turn really, really quickly here. So he's down. So I have Trutraxa here as my nuker. You could run any single target nuker or even an AoE nuker in that spot. Doesn't matter really who it is. Someone who's going to be killing the opponent, right? So then we get a turn meter boost. We're going to go with another Stinging Blast here. Hits pretty hard, again, on Bashers, both of his AoE attacks. I don't want Skull Crusher to go here. Skull Crown, excuse me. So I think I'm just going to go to fully deplete her turn meter here. We might lose Basher. We do. No big deal, though. And then it looks like we're going to finally be able to kill these guys. And again, you can see the turn meter manipulation. Now, Trutraxa has a shot at removing this unkillable. We're going to try for it right here. And we do. Remove buff and kill. And then she'll be able to take down Valkyrie. Maybe? She does. So first round victory. So just kind of to post-mortem that first team, right? We're looking at going first. We're looking at having a control champion to land provokes, stuns, freezes, something that negates the other team's ability to go next. For a long time, I was just running sleep. So Kaimar, in the beginning of Raid Shadow Legends, he was one of the first legendaries I pulled, thankfully. I just put the entire opponents to sleep, their entire team. Then I debuffed them. And then from there, I went with a debuff that didn't do any damage off of Madame Ceres. And then from there, I just kind of individually, single target, nuked them all down, right? You can use even a champion like, Soulbound Bowyer, you know, in terms of a rare champion who has that capability. Let's go up next here with next team, nuke team, right? So a nuke comp, again, speed is imperative. Speed is super important, right? And that sucks, but it is a speed battle. It is what it is. I'd be lying if I said it was anything but. So Arbiter's going first. Arbiter in this team, it's important to have a speed lead and a turn meter booster, both of those components on your nuking comp. In this case, it happens to be the same champion, Arbiter. That's why she's so good. She's a speed lead with 30% speed aura, and she has a turn meter booster by 30% in her kit. I have two turn meter boosters on this team. So let's pretend you didn't have Arbiter, you didn't have another good turn meter booster. Well, you probably, hopefully you have Apothecary or a Seeker or a champion like that with a turn boost. You could sub in for Apothecary in for Arbiter here, or for Arbiter, you could have a Skullcrown who has a good speed lead aura, or a Gorgorab who has a good speed lead aura with a turn meter booster, such as, again, a Seeker, a Hikatoon, or an Apothecary on the team, okay? So, and then you put those two champions with a debuffer. Madame Ceres is my example here, War Maiden, Tayrell, a Stagnite, champions like that. And then a nuker at the end, an AoE nuker at the end. So I have Trunda, who is a beast mode nuker, obviously, but you can go with basically any nuker. You know, there's a plethora of great AoE nuking options in the game. So here's turn meter booster, boom. Now we're gonna go another turn meter boost. Actually, we don't even need it right now, but I'm gonna use it anyway. This is gonna give my team at least a speed buff as well. So speed buff. But you can see this is working out perfectly here. We do have a frozen Arbiter, but I have immunity gear. And this is really good too. If you're going against a lot of Tormunds, taking a hit on the quality of your gear in exchange for having immunity gear, which is farmed in Fire Knight, is really advantageous as you push into Gold Arena and beyond. So I have immunity gear on Trunda and Ceres on this team. So she's gonna go next. She's going to go ahead and place the decrease attack, decrease defense on the entire enemy team, and it's going to set the table beautifully for our lovely dwarf here, Trunda. So Trunda's going to go up next. Boom, nuke him down. Kill them all, except for Tormund. Now we're just going to go on auto from here on out. But again, guys, this is a quintessential nuking team. There's room for hybrid opportunities between these teams as well. So let's see what we can do here on our... Oh, my God. Well, that wasn't the start we wanted here against this third team. I told you, it is what it is, right? So this is my resist team. This is a work in progress here, the resist team. The idea on a resist team is your team is going second. Unfortunately, we ran into, well, we ran into four of the best arena champions in the game, right? In Arbiter, Seris, Foley, and Mountain King. And unfortunately, even though we have great champions ourselves, we lost to Valkyrie and Razzan Scarhide off the bat. So not ideal. We can revive one of them, but I have a feeling we're just gonna die in between. So I'm gonna revive. We block revival because Foley killed him. So we have no choice here but to go ahead and buff the team and see what we can do here. We definitely want to go after Arbiter first. So let's see if we can. We do kill Arbiter. That's going to be a help. But can we keep these guys alive? No, we can't. It's going to be Mountain King versus a squad of three. Anyway, guys, we're going to lose this match. But I do want to break down the team to you guys nonetheless. I think we're going to lose the match, right? Yeah, we're going to lose. It wasn't close. I was going to say it was kind of close at the end. It wasn't really close. The idea, let me go ahead and just go auto on another team here until we get to that third team, because I spent too much time distracted by losing and not enough time actually talking about the comp and how it works. So again, going through this control team, going through the next team, but the resist team is more tricky, and it is, in my opinion, outside of the fact that speed is so crucial, it's way more gear dependent. To build a high resist team or a very strong defensive team, you need to essentially allow the opponents to take their turns first. Taking their turns first is difficult to stay alive. You saw that I had difficulty staying alive with a Siffy and a Mountain King and really strong champions on my team. So it's not gonna always work out. And this is the team, the third team, the deny team, that really scales a lot based on artifacts, right? There's no tricks involved in terms of you don't have that CC champion who's able to put them all to sleep or reduce their turn meter or stun them or freeze them. So you just have to make sure you keep your champions alive. Now, with a lot of denial teams, they'll build their Siffy to be very, very fast. That's something that I don't have on my team, which I would advise you guys do. So again, that makes that third team also dependent on speed, which is unfortunate. But the reason I say that is if Siffy goes fast, and if she goes first, she'll put an increased defense and a block debuffs and increased speed on the rest of my team. Most importantly, the block debuffs. Any champion, such as a Grizzled Jarl, who's going to be putting a block debuffs on your deny or resist team is going to be helping you exponentially, because then you won't get that defense down that the opponents did on my champions there, allowing them to one-shot two of my strongest champions on their first AoE nuke. So it's actually, in my opinion, a little bit advantageous that we lost that match, because it shows you that the really good resist teams in the game, let's see if we win this one. The really good resist teams in the game, they will have their Siffy or their block debuffs champion still being very fast and still going first, okay? So now we have Valkyrie going first here. She's going to put a shield on all my champions. Now we can have the Whirlwind Romance. There's going to be increased defense, increased speed, and block debuffs. And now this is how the team is supposed to be working here. So there's going to be decreased turn meter on all of the opponents with Razzan. And now we can just start nuking them all down with Mountain King. So who do we want to go after first here? Might as well go after, I guess, Venus here. Why not? And then we can pretty much go on auto. But you can see with all these buffs up, check it out. Shield, an OP Valkyrie shield, counterattack, increased speed, block debuffs, increased defense. There's no way you're killing my team if I can withstand the first round against you. So let's go ahead and do one more team, one more round after this. This is on auto right now, but it doesn't even matter. I mean, it's just, there's no way you're killing this team at this point, so here we go, debuffs blocked. We have a resist lead. You can also run a defense lead on a team like this. Let's run through one more team here, guys. Let's go against this dude, who is the toughest opponent that I have in terms of trophies to gain. Let's see, does he have a Torment? He does. Want to make sure my immunity gear is there. We're looking pretty good. Let's do this. In terms of gear on these champions, guys, again, speed is going to be crucial for your speed boosters, and that's all you care about, believe it or not. In the arena, it doesn't matter if it doesn't matter if your speed booster has pretty low defense or pretty low attack or whatever. It's only about speed gear. So for example, I think I have one of my, I forgot, maybe Lissandra. She has like HP flat stat gauntlets on her. because I only care about speed. I don't care if it's a crap piece of gauntlets, because if she's not going first, she's dead anyway, you know? So that's something to take into consideration. Also, for your attacker, if you have really solid CC on your team, you can put your nuker, you can flirt with the idea of putting your nuker in attack-based or defense-based, if their damage is based on defense, usually it's gonna be attack boots instead of speed. Just be careful about that. As you progress in this game, it's been my personal experience that that doesn't scale that well. Usually, even on a platinum tier nuking team, usually you're gonna need to put your nuker in speed boots. So speed boots pretty much across the board on all these champions. Even on my resist and deny team, I still have speed boots, I think, on at least two of those champions. Siphi, definitely, and Valkyrie, definitely. I'm not 100% sure on, I think even Razin's in speed boots. I think Mountain King's the only one, and he's in HP boots, okay? So here we go, the next team. Again, you're kind of seeing how it all works here. Decrease, nuke, kill, destroy, auto for Tormund. So again, guys, I hope this is kind of illustrated that, you know, I touched on this on my five quick tips that will really change your account dramatically. One final note on all these teams is that turn meter matters a lot. I'm sorry, turns, they, not turn meter, the order of these champions matters a lot, right? You really want, again, your speed booster or your biggest buffer to go first. In this case, it's Valkyrie with the shield, or Siphi with the block debuffs. In the other cases, it's your turn meter booster and then your debuffer, and then your nuker goes last. You don't want your nuker going before your damage dealers. Hopefully that's pretty apparent to you guys, but I think it's worth saying, worth mentioning here, right? And again, we're in this great position. We're going against another Valkyrie on their team. They have a very solid kind of denial team as well, but I think my team's better. We'll go ahead and see if I end up eating crow on that. But again, I mean, look at this. Look at how much damage they're doing, or lack thereof, right? It's really, really solid, this squad, this team. So let's go ahead and start taking them down one by one. Mountain King's gonna be slow, as I mentioned earlier, because he is, I think my Mountain King has, you know, I don't think he has 100k HP, but he has a lot of HP. And that's because he has HP boots on him, HP percentage. Razin might die here, actually, let's see. But again, you guys get the feel of how a resist team works. Another guy is Mausoleum Mage. You could put him in here, build him with a very high resist, put that, again, block debuffs, increased defense on your team. He's a great option if you don't have Siphi or if you don't have Grizzled Jarl on your team. Those are champions I would definitely identify that are really crucial in building a really fun denial team. And again, I will end on that note. Denial is the least popular of the three teams I've kind of showed you in today's video, but it's also one of the more fun teams when it works, as you saw in the last two matches. So guys, thank you so much for watching this video. I hope it helped you guys out. At the very least, I hope you found it semi-entertaining and informative, guys. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the content here, I invite you to subscribe to the channel. Thanks, and as always, take care, guys.